Honey as a video was the first time I really got to do what I wanted in a video. I really had fun. Like, when I look back, even though we shot like 20-hour days, that was Paul Hunter directing that, and we did literally in Puerto Rico, where I wrote the song on this boat, because Q-Tip had given me a loop of Body Rock, and then Puffy and Stevie J and everybody all, we got, it was sort of a big collabo. But I wrote the song on this little catamaran that I go to, this little island, this place, and I saw people jet skiing from back and forth to this, from this bigger island to the little island, so I'm like, that'd be cute for this video. So anyway, we put it together, but that's the first video that I really can say, like, that was me being able to be me. And even like the fact that I had my hair off my face, like, you would never see that before. It always, there's always people with the blah, 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 you know? And the thing that's funny is I really didn't set out to do that video to slay anybody or to, like, you know, but I'm sure subconsciously what I was going through and, like, escaping one part of my life, I'm sure that was going on in the back of my head. But really, it was just an excuse for me to wear a wetsuit and a bikini. It's, yeah, and the pumps. It's really quite basic. You know, if you're never allowed to wear anything but Pumas and a freaking shirt in a field tied up to here, you know, heaven forbid the button goes down to here, it's all over. You know, what was I supposed to do? I just wanted to swim in the Gucci pumps. And who wouldn't? I mean, really. But I must say, the controversy surrounding it, looking back on it, I do understand why people thought it. And it's just funny, because that's just, I just really wanted to do some spy, James Bond, Barbarella type thing. Doing Heartbreaker, it was definitely a longer process, because a lot of like little kids will come up to be like, you know what video I like? When you're fighting that girl with the black hair, and I'm like, that girl is me. You know, like, some people really still don't know and didn't recognize me as that character. And so I did have a stunt double, but that's only because when I was fighting against myself, she had to be me, and vice versa. So when you see me getting dragged on the ground and doing the kicks, like, I did all that stuff myself. Actually, my brother is a fifth-degree black belt, so he used to make me do, like, you know, roundhouse kicks and all this nonsense from the time I was like 6 years old. So, you know, he was critiquing that. But yeah, I went home the first night and I was so sore, like, I couldn't move just from doing my stunts. Then when I had to do it the second day, it was crazy, but it was, you know, it was fun. My bands with five of her friends. She wanna creep past the block spying again. She wanna roll with Jay, chase skios away. She wanna fight with lame chicks, blow my day. She wanna... That period, I'm not quite sure where Bianca came from. I think, okay, the woman who I worked with for a long time, and still, you know, when I get some more time, again, would love to go back and do some more work. As she's an acting coach. I've just been crazy and doing a million things. But when I said I was going to play two different characters, she was like, you should really do something. It'd be cool if you do something that's really opposite of you, like Ice Queen, because I'm not like that. So when we developed, like, the mannerisms and that type of stuff, it was like I started being in that character of that person. And one of the things I do is, like, I'll always do characters or accents or imitate people, you know, like, that I grew up around. And another form of escapism. And so Bianca, I just, like, suddenly started thinking, she probably has an accent. Excuse me, No matter what, like, the lesson I learned this year, nobody is gonna like me. I can't expect everybody to be my best friend. You know, stop overcompensating and trying to be best friends with the world, because it's just never gonna be. So it's like some people will judge me, and I don't hate them for it, because I would sit at home with the TV on like, oh, you have problems. I feel so bad for you. You're rich. You're on TV. Next. You know what I mean? It's like I understand it. Just like I understand that the press's job is to sensationalize stuff. Their job is to sell papers. So if selling papers means making up a story from nothing, like the latest rumor I heard was a classic, that I won't walk on carpet. I refuse to walk on a carpeted floor. I'm like, okay, so how do I get from point A to point B? Do I fly? Or perhaps I bring people in to lift me and, oh, okay, that's what, they lift me and carry me. Yeah, that's a good one. Anytime you say hello to somebody in a hallway, that's your new boyfriend, you know? And I've come to realize that they read it one day, and then they're wrapping fish with it the next day. It's not that deep. Come on, break my
heart. Give me your love.
Give me your love.
Give me your love.
It was a lot of fun making the Loverboy video. I mean, I actually almost passed out in the desert. It was so hot. It was like, you know, and I'm like, you know, spinning around like a top in the middle of the desert, and it was just whatever. But I liked riding on top of the car. That was fun. And David LaChapelle is like he's a great artist. He's done some of the best photography, in my opinion, like of our time. So he's always fun and crazy to work with. And you asked me about the boots. I feel like I'm doing a promo for Dolce & Gabbana, and I hope those are their boots. I believe they are, because I almost didn't wear the boots. But then everyone's like, they're hot. And usually I don't like patterns too much, but I got to admit, I liked them with the little pink thing. It was very Barbie to me. I'm into Barbie. The texture of the soundtrack is interesting, because what I tried to do is, when you see the movie, you'll feel the ballads that I wrote, like, sort of in the voice of the character, but that are still relatable to me or to anybody else. And a lot of people are saying to me, you sound so much more emotional or something when we hear you on these songs. And I think it's maybe because I went through the experience of making this film and living as this character for like 3 months. And then also, I've had this idea for like 3.5 years. So, and I finished the vocals after I finished the movie. Billy's a girl who grows up in a foster home. Her mother, she's taken away from her mother when she's a little girl, because her mom's an addict, and something happens and she has to be taken away. So basically, everything she does, oh, she has, you know, she meets these two girls in the foster home. One is played by Brat, who is hilarious in this movie. Actually, if we could only show her outtakes, I would watch that movie. That'd be my favorite. And one is played by Tia Texada, who was in Nurse Betty and a lot of other movies. And they become Billy, my character's best friends, and we're like this extended family, you know, when we're finally like grown up and whatever. But everything Billy does is to compensate for that loss that she feels about her mom. Even like she falls in love with this DJ, and they're kind of trying to make it together, and then the record company's in there and they have the power, and it's whatever. Too many things to mention right now. But the thing that's different about the songs that I wrote for this movie and soundtrack is that, like, I wrote them in the voice of Billy. Very not my life story. Though my life story would be an interesting movie, but it'd take like 3 volumes, and we don't know the ending yet.